there are a couple of procedures that we've been doing, and we've been keeping us like really busy, which is basically the treatment of acute stroke, so-called the mechanical thrombectomy. The other types of procedure we do quite often is the treatment of brain aneurysms. So different type of potential stroke, right? So this the acute ischemic stroke is from a blockage in the blood vessel that goes to the brain, so it limits and impairs the blood flow to the brain. On the other hand, the hemorrhagic type of stroke, which is usually like a bleed in the brain or in the within like the space that it's actually adjacent, involving the brain. And those are the other types of procedures that we do. When, you know, when the aneurysms present, they can be either ruptured when they already bled, or unruptured when they're like, they haven't bled, but potentially they present with a hemorrhagic problem. So that's when we actually treat them either before they rupture or, you know, when it becomes an emergency, which when after they rupture. So basically when you have the acute stroke, the acute ischemic stroke that is caused by what we call like a large vessel occlusion, meaning a blood clot is basically blocking the blood flow through one of the main arteries in the brain. That's when we really like come into like it's there's this procedure that has been performed like now for several years, but really like only this last like couple of years we really have very good scientific data. What gives those patients the best chance of a good outcome? And the way we do it, we bring this patient super quickly to the angio suite. We put catheters through their groin. We go up there and using some specific device, one that looks like a stent in a stick, and other devices that are big catheters that aspirate the clot. We use either or sometimes a combination of both. We basically use those devices to remove the clot and unblocking that blood vessel, restoring the normal blood flow to the brain. In regards to aneurysms, there's new technology coming out almost like every 6 months, you know? So, you know, coils started in the late 90s and really what put like endovascular treatment of brain aneurysms in the map. And then we had the advance of balloons and then stents and now the flow diverters. And very soon we're going to have what we call like intrasaccular flow disruptors. So it's going to be like almost like a cage-like mesh that we're going to put inside the aneurysm. Depending on the type, of course, it depends on the type of the aneurysm, where it's located, size. But those are all techniques and technologies that's going to be available for treat most of the patients in the very near future.